Okay, moving on to the President's Report. John?
Okay. First of all, I'm glad that you're all here. Thank you for coming and spending the afternoon with us. We do have a bunch of things actually to brag about this year. I'll start by letting you know where we stand. At this point, our ridership so far this year, as of yesterday, is up 14.5% over last year. And we have so far hauled 26,253 people as opposed to 22,934 last year. So we're 3,319 people ahead of the same time last year. Our reservation information is even better. At this point, we have reserved 30,810 people as of yesterday, and that number is higher than the total of all ridership last year, and we're still in September, with a week to go in September. So we're very proud of that. I am personally very proud of the effort that has been made by all of our employees in Antonito and in Chama, and our marketing team and our commission to help us reach these goals. These things look even better. Of course, we all have our individual situations as railroads, and Lord knows we've been through some tough times. But this year, the Cumbrian Toltec is the only one of the Rocky Mountain scenic railroads, historic tourist railroads, whose ridership is up. The Royal Gorge is down for the year. Durango and Silverton is down for the year. Georgetown Loop is down for the year. And the San Luis and Rio Grande is also down for the year. There are a variety of reasons for each of those things. But we are not simply having our boat rise with a rising tide. So, part of this, part of this has been done, is the result of a very active marketing strategy that we put in place and got approved at the March Commission meeting. It is our strategy now to grow the ridership first. It's a three-year plan. Grow the ridership first, and then work on growing the revenue for the company. The intent there is, as we grow the ridership, not only does that help fill the trains and reduce the per seat cost of running the trains, but it also provides more people in both communities to help the business community in both Antonito and in Chama. And that is one of our missions.
Not right now. Please let him finish the report.
Part of our success this year has been a very active public relations campaign. We have hosted, and we'd like to thank those of you who have helped host the FAM trips that we have run. Those have produced good press for us, and that has certainly helped. We have recently been named by New Mexico Magazine as the number one place to come see the fall colors in the state. That helps. Among the other things that have occurred, one that I'd kind of like to brag about, is CNN Travel has put us on the list of 49 journeys that will change your life. This includes things like going from Moscow to Vladivostok, Russia, by train, going up to the 101st, the 89th floor of the Taipei Hotel in Taiwan, trekking across Africa. So being listed as one of the 49 journeys that will change your life is a big coup for the Cumbrians and Toltec. and we expect to see dividends coming from that. So briefly, that's where we are operationally. I'll give you a couple of other little pieces of information here. We have, at this point, four serviceable locomotives. 484 is not quite done yet. The 487, the 88, and the 89 are running acceptably. The 463, we are taking a little care of. It's still going to require some work that we will complete this winter before we consider putting it into regular daily service out of either end of the railroad. The passenger cars are behaving in ways we're proud of. Of course, we have repainted everything, and we get good feedback from our customers about the look and appearance of our train. We also get very good feedback about the service provided on our train from our onboard service personnel. In terms of charter and special trains, I have a report, but it's probably too long to read here. I will provide a copy to go in the minutes. Okay. For that. We provided Saturday evening dinner service. We've provided a number of charters. We filmed a major Hollywood movie out of Antonito in June of this year. We have got three other movies that we're filming this year, two of which we've already filmed, one of which is still to occur in October. Beyond that, what I would like to do is take an opportunity now to introduce our new marketing manager, Lenore Abbott. Lenore has taken on now the position of marketing manager. She is following through on the strategic plan that we put in place and approved in March. I'm very happy to welcome her aboard. She has a little presentation to you. It's not a detail of what we're going to be doing, but a detail of how we will be looking at what we do so that the information, the decisions that we make going forward are not based on just seat of the pants gut feel about where we are, but are based on data so we can make smart decisions.
Thank you.